Good morning. Welcome to Be Your Best, Make Things Happen. It's so good to be here this morning. I just want to say a very big thank you to everyone that has come on board this morning. Happy Democracy Day to everyone in Nigeria, and if you're staying outside of Nigeria. Today, 29th of May, is Democracy Day. I just want to say Happy Democracy Day. If you are in Nigeria, I hope you are planning to get some rest today and re-energize, re-strategize for the week ahead. It's few more days to the end of the month of May, and we're about to enter into the month of June. I pray that these few days and even the month of June will be one of the best months for you. I know many people are not very happy with the things that are going on in our nation today, with the state of things. Many of us wish things were really better, but I guess it's not all bad. Especially this past weekend, if you're an Arsenal fan or a Man U fan, I'm sure you had something to smile about or something to celebrate about. So I guess things will definitely get better. Things will definitely improve. That's our prayer, that things will definitely improve. Things will get better. We'll be able to have the enabling environment to be able to achieve our goals, achieve our targets, be better people, help make our environments better. And I believe that you and I can make this happen. So I just want to say once again, thank you for coming on. Hi, Bima's World. Thank you for joining. I just want to say thank you for being on Be Your Best and Make Things Happen this morning. It's 20 minutes of inspiration, motivation, leadership, purpose, and success. And I'm very sure that you will have a great time. I released my book last month. That was month of April, towards the end of last month, Beconomy, Becoming All You Are Created to Be. In the book, I talk about 32 life lessons to help you on your creative journey, on your journey towards creative expression. 32 life lessons that I've specifically drawn out from my life that I believe can help you. Because one thing that I've realized is that for one of the greatest values of the human spirit is creative expression. We want to express ourselves creatively. We want to display our gifts, we want to showcase our talents, we want to show people what we can do. So that's why I took out time to write out this book, to break it down and share these 32 life lessons that I believe can help anyone to express themselves creatively. I don't know if you have seen it. Hi, Mr. Awesome. Yeah, if you haven't seen it, if you go on my page, on my bio, the link is there, beconomy.pagedemo.co. Once you click on it, you'll be able to access the first chapter for free. You just download it in a matter of seconds. So you read it and let me know what you think. But I also want to say thank you to everyone who has actually downloaded the book, and I've gotten around to read it. I've been getting some feedback. I just want to say thank you so much for taking our time to read it. Specifically here, I have something that some people have said about the book. I just want to read it out for you quickly so that you can hear. Specifically, I have one of my friends here, TP Malgui. He read the book. He says, I'll just read it out for you so that you can hear. He says, Hello, Kay. Apologies for the delay in replying. I've been quite busy the past couple of days and have finally got round to reading through. The book is fantastic, my man. the message is relevant, content is spot on, and your delivery is really humorous. I made a few notes which I have enumerated as bullet points below. Number one, maybe use a Black African model for the book cover. Number two, I especially like how you use movie quotes and scenarios to make your points. Brilliant. Same for the use of your self-experiences as talking points. Makes the book more authentic. My favorite bits have to be the meme headers, the 1 million naira. Actually, that particular subtitle is I beg you get 1 million naira where you know they use. It's pigeon, Nigerian pigeon for please do you have 1 million naira to spare? And it's quite funny because how many people really have 1 million naira to spare and you are like asking them for it. So that's what that it's actually a funny meme that has been going around online. I don't know maybe if you have seen it or not, but I used that meme to actually draw out a point, and many people that have read it actually liked it. He also says he likes the meme header Witches and Wizards. There I talk about how here in Africa, most of the time when things are not working, we always attribute it to the fact that there's some dark force working against you somewhere. And I point out there that if we keep focusing on the fact that there are dark forces working against us, we will not really make any progress. It's not as if there are no contrary forces, but making them our singular focus will prevent us from making necessary progress. Well, welcome, Philamian, and welcome, Bafo. Welcome. Then he also says he likes the subchapter, Udeme is a great man. It's an ad that was running on the local Nigerian stations some years ago. It's this Guinness ad, and it talks about greatness, how a man left the village to come to the city and then encounter greatness. I use that to also draw some points. And finally, TP says, since you do work or corporate counseling, why not remodel and trademark the book as a learning tool, complete with self-assessment exercises? Based on the scenarios mentioned in the write-up, might open up a few more avenues to monetize the book. Keep it up, K. You are well on your way to becoming the Nigerian Robert Kiyosaki. Well, I don't know about that, but thank you so much for that feedback, TP. Another feedback that I have here is from my mentor, Steve Harris. He says, the greatest treasures are hidden in the least obvious places, and Kayode Kolade has shown where the greatest treasures reside in you. The Economy is an amazing book that helps you discover your own personal economy and put it to good use. Get yours now, Steve Harris, Life and Business Strategist. Just pardon me, I'll just take one more. This one is by Shiba Manya. She says, while reading through the book, my mind was picturing and putting together how I could implement the keys to becoming self-reliant, self-sufficient, and how much greatness I can add to this world with my uniqueness. The author made me realize how much I take little things like skills and even hobbies for granted. And then it struck me, this could be the key to my breakthrough, being that I have a passion for skills development and empowerment. I consider this book all-encompassing. It is motivational, humorous. It contains current happenings, successes. It teaches common sense, and it sparks something in you that you never knew existed or that you were taking for granted. I believe readers will be pumped to wake up and do something exceptional with their lives. The book teaches life hacks and shows you how everyday people transformed into juggernauts in their own unique ways. I strongly recommend you read it. Thank you so much, Shiba, for that feedback. Welcome, Expensive Diamond. So that's some of the feedback on the book, Economy, Becoming All You Are Created to Be, 32 Life Lessons to Help You on Your Journey Towards Creative Expression. I assure you, it's not like anything you have read in recent time. It's very unconventional. It's just concise, straight to the point, and different in and different. The book, the title of the book is Becoming All You Are Created to Be. Or specifically, the way I put it is that the economy of becoming all you are created to be, the economy of becoming all you are created to be. If you go on my page, you'll see the link there in my bio, becoming.pagedemo.co. Once you click it, in a few seconds, you get the first chapter for free. It just comes on your phone. So please read it and let me know what you think. I assure you that you'll definitely enjoy it. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Expensive Diamond. So that's that. Yes, Beconomy. Yes, Beconomy. That's the title, Beconomy. Exactly, you got it perfectly. So if you just go to my page, you'll be able to download it. I promised 20 minutes, so the time is far spent. So let me just quickly move on to what I said I was going to just talk about briefly today. I promised I was going to answer two questions today. Remember that it's be your best, make things happen with me. So we're making it happen together. Thank you so much, each and all of you that have joined me this morning. I promised I was going to answer two questions. The first question is, how does a person know when to persist or when to just give up working on a project? How does a person know when to persist or when to just give up working on a project? And the second question is, how do you stay focused on the long term despite the ups and downs? So those are the two questions I'm going to be answering. So straight to the first question, how does a person know when to persist or when to just give up working on a project, especially when it just looks like you are not making the kind of progress you wish you really like to see yourself make? So I'll just say first off that the reason why we ask ourselves that first question is most of the time is fear, where we are afraid that we are going to lose something, probably we are going to lose our reputation, we are going to lose respect, we are going to lose time working on that project. We fear that, working on this project, is it even going to matter in the end? I think that's a major question many of us ask ourselves. This thing I'm doing, like when I started posting quotes, pictures to inspire people, motivate people on Instagram and on social media, I kept asking myself, is this thing going to matter in the end? Is this thing going to eventually make sense? As in, because the truth about it is, I was in the corporate world. I used to work in the bank, and I resigned from the bank and saying, "Okay, this is what I wanted. This is what I want to do." And so, in doing that, I kept telling myself, "Look, is this thing going to matter? Is this thing going to be relevant eventually, when you are doing?" So that's one of the questions we keep asking ourselves: that okay, do I keep doing this, or do I just stop? So I think that fear is. It's actually one of the major reasons why we ask ourselves. So it's not now. It's how do we address that fear? Many people say yes that look, it's we used to say look, overcome the fear. But many of us have come to realize now that it's not about overcoming the fear. It's about turning that fear into fuel and saying okay, how can I use this fear as a form of motivation? How can I use this fuel to drive myself to the next level? And I say that yes, it's very possible, because if you are afraid that okay, this thing that I'm doing, what I'm going I want to say to people or what I want to write, is this going to be accepted? Is it going to be well received? It simply means that you care about what you are doing. If you didn't care, you wouldn't be bothered with if anybody accepted it or rejected it or not. So the fact that you care about that particular project, it's the singular pointer to the fact that what you are doing is valuable. Number one, it's pointer to the fact that you are valuable, and you value your worth, you value your reputation, you value your personality, and it's also proof that what you're actually doing is valuable. So instead of allowing that fear of rejection stop you, let it be the fuel that says, look, this thing that is valuable, this value that I have, this value that I carry on my inside, this project that I believe is valuable, I must release it for the world to see. I must put it out there for the world to see. And many of the times we keep saying, okay, I put myself out there and I got rejected, I got turned down. But there are just some times when we need to take a step back and think about, okay, instead of focusing on trying to get acceptance from getting acceptance from those people who have rejected us, why not, or focus on those people who we are trying to get acceptance from, why not we focus on those who have accepted us for who we are already? The truth about it is that there are certain people in your life right now that you don't need to do anything to impress them. You don't need to do anything for them. They just accept you for who you are. So maybe this is just a particular time that you need to reconnect with some of those people. This is also to that this certain people that are listening to me right now, that you are indeed in a relationship with certain people. You really like these people. You want their affirmation. You want their acceptance. Yes, it would be nice for you to get their acceptance and affirmation, but it's instead of focusing all your energy on these particular people that you are trying to gain their acceptance and you don't have them already, why not focus on those people who have accepted you for who you are already? That might just be the fuel that you need to carry on this on that particular project that you are excuse me, that you are working on. Secondly, I would say that another reason why you may be feeling like giving up on that particular project that you're working on right now is because you are trying to do it all alone. One thing you need to ask yourself is that, what support can I get on this particular project that I'm working on? And still, I'm sure some people will say, well, I've tried to get support from certain people. The support is not just coming. But one thing I can assure you is that there is somebody out there that is ready to support you with advice, with encouragement, with wisdom to take you to the next level on that project. So keep looking, you will definitely find that person. Keep looking, you definitely. And that's also why I'm here, to tell you that, look, if you have been thinking of giving up on that project, don't give up. I'm here to tell you that, look, I'm here to support you with encouragement. I'm here to support you with my words to say that, look, don't give up on that project. You will definitely find people that are willing to support you. Now, finally, remember that it's not about the project turning out perfectly. It's about starting the journey. That's just the truth. It's about starting the journey. It's about daring. It's about daring to take a step. It's about daring to do something. It's about daring to try something new. And the truth about it is that you are a lot better than several other people who haven't dared. You are a lot better than several other people who haven't tried anything. You are a lot better than several other people who are just sitting there, sitting on the sidelines. So the fact that you actually started that project should give you some sense of value, should give you some sense of motivation. You have grown far beyond every other person that didn't dare anything. So don't look at yourself as a failure, or don't look at that project as a failure. Look at it also as a growth process for you. Look at it as a learning curve for you. I believe, I hope that has been helpful in any way. Welcome, Benny. Welcome, Abbas. Thank you for joining. So, having said that, do you to persist on a project? So let's come to the giving up part. The truth about it is that there are just some projects that you embark on and you just have to tell yourself, you look, you know what? I can't go any longer on this project. I personally have I experienced something like that just very recently, just even some weeks ago. I just had to let go of something because that particular project was taking so much from me. And but the thing that I actually did was that I passed the project through these three things that I talked about Am I getting enough support? I started the journey, yes, and I had enjoyed the process thus far, but I just got to a point where I just had to tell myself, you know what, look, I just have to put aside this project. Why? Because it was now taking so much from me, and not just from me, but from all those around me. And specifically, what was beginning to happen was that that particular project was becoming everything that was in my focus, everything that was in my view. It now the project that singular project became my vision. So one thing I would say is that how do you know when to just say no or to just give up on a particular project? I would say that when that project becomes all encompassing, you can't see anything before you anymore. You can't visualize. The truth about it is that what gives us energy as humans is the ability to visualize, the ability to see beyond the now. And when you are in a particular situation, the reason why many people feel frustrated is because they can't see beyond their present circumstance. They can't see beyond now. And when you have any project that has become so challenging that you can't see beyond that particular moment anymore, that you can't see a better future that it's awaiting you, then I think that may be a time you may need to begin to consider and say, look, I think it's time for me to move on to something else and just let go of this particular project. But most importantly, just like I said, don't feel like a failure. The fact that you started that project is proof that you are valuable, you have something valuable to offer to the world, and that you are a lot better than even those that didn't even dare to try anything in the first place. So, to the second question, how do you stay focused on the long term despite the ups and downs? I would just simply say, learn to celebrate small victories. My mentor puts it like this, that it's like going on a journey, traveling by road, that's if you stay in Nigeria now, traveling by road from Lagos to Abuja. Now, Abuja is your long term goal, but just because Abuja is your long term goal, that doesn't mean you shouldn't celebrate the fact that you have gotten to Ibadan. Ibadan is just like an hour away from Lagos, but several hours away from Abuja. So just because you are still several hours away from Abuja, you are no longer where you were, even though you are not where you want to be. So celebrate that place where you are. And another thing that is important about celebrating where you are is because of the fact that where you are is proof that where you want to be exists. The fact that you are no longer where you used to be and you've moved, even if it's just one step, the fact that you have moved is proof that you can still move to where you want to get to. So the Ibadan is proof that Abuja exists. On the way, for many of us that know that road network very much, I know you get to Lokoja, you get to Ore, you get to some places in Ogun State, Osun State, you get to some places in Edo State. The fact that you get to each and every one of those landmarks is proof that your long-term goal of Abuja exists. So celebrate those short-term victories. Now, to the person who says, okay, that look, Kayode, I must be honest with you, there has been no short-term victory at all in my life. Everything has just been down, 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 down on this journey. There has been no short-term victory at all. Everything is just not working. I'll just simply say that, okay, what makes you feel everything is not working? What makes you feel you are a failure? What makes you feel you are just failing at everything? The reason why you feel that you are not succeeding or you are failing at everything is because you have certain standards for success, Abby. You have certain measurements, you have certain parameters as your standards for success. Now, beautiful. The fact that you feel you are a failure or you feel that you have failed is proof that you can succeed. It's like the famous yin yang of the Chinese history and all that, where it's the opposites exist. And what it simply means is that one cannot exist without the other. They call it the law of the universe. one cannot exist, that light cannot exist without darkness. The two is responsible for keeping the world as it is. So the fact that you feel, or you may say you don't feel, you know that there's failure in your life, is proof that you can actually succeed. It's proof that success also exists. It's not just all failure in this world. It's not just all failure in your world. If you feel that there's failure in your world, it's proof that there's also success in your world. So instead of focusing on that failure, why not tap into the success in your world? Because it's there. I assure you it's there. Just because if you are so certain that there's failure, you are ready to give up hope, you are just ready to throw in the towel. One thing I want to assure you is that, look, just refocus. Success exists in that your world. No matter how hopeless that situation is, you will definitely find it. It's like how there's this rock band that I like. They are called Switchfoot. There's this song. The title of one of their songs is "The Shadow Proves the Sunshine." So the shadow proves the sunshine. So the proof that there's shadow in your life is proof that there's also the sunshine. So all you just need is to change your focus a little bit, change your strategy a little bit. Connect with me, Kayode, that is here. I'm always here for you. And let's make things happen. Let's turn things around. Let's turn that shadow into sunshine. Let's turn that failure into success. And I am very sure that you and I will have a lot of things to celebrate very soon, definitely. Welcome to Minatius. Welcome. Thank you for joining. So that's just how I'll put it. I hope you've gotten something from what I've had to say today. How do you stay focused on long-term goals despite your long-term goals despite all the ups and downs? Celebrate small victories. Redirect your attention. There's definitely success in your life. It's waiting to happen. How do you know when to persist or when to give up on setting goals? Get little momentum, connect with people who love you, who accept you already, get support on that for that particular project, and then remember that it's not about the project turning out perfectly. It's about daring, it's about taking steps, it's about growing and becoming everything that you are created to be. I just want to say thank you for everyone who has stayed on thus far on this broadcast. I have a special gift for every one of you that has stayed on till this time. I mentioned my book that I came out last month, The Economy of Becoming All You Are Created to Be, 32 Life Lessons to Help You on Your Journey Towards Creative Expression. I'm giving that book away to every one of you for free on the link on my bio. It's the link for just the first chapter of the book. But for each and every one of us, each and every one of you that have stayed with me on this broadcast till now, what you just do for me is that let me have your email. Also on my bio, my email is there. Just send me an email that you watched this broadcast. Send me an email that you watched this broadcast, and I will send you the entire book for free. I'll send you the entire book for free. It's just my gift to you, my just to say thank you for being here with me. This is my very first live broadcast. I hope I didn't do too badly. I hope you got something. So send me, please just go on my page and send me an email. Click on my email, send me an email, and I will send you the book for free. The Economy of Becoming All You Are Created to Be, 32 Life Lessons to Help You on Your Journey Towards Creative Expression. I just want to say thank you once again. Happy Democracy Day to all everyone in Nigeria. I do hope you have a very restful day. For those of you that want to go out, I hope you have fun and you enjoy yourselves. I look forward to doing this again with us, same time next week. So just turn on the notification on my page. Let's connect. Let's talk. Also, let me know what you would like me to talk about. send in your questions. It's better. Just send me your questions. Let's see how we can tackle them and answer them together. And I'm sure we'll definitely have a great time. So let's make this happen every Monday. Let's make this happen every Monday. Let's continue to connect. Let's continue to talk. Let's continue to share our unique perspectives. And I know that I'll definitely see you at the top. Thank you once again. Thank you, Expressive Diamond. Thank you so much. And thank you once again. Till I see you next week, please do remember your greatness is very sure.